Hello, welcome to this channel, Gain Java Knowledge. And today in this video, we are going to create a simple Kafka consumer. And this consumer will consume the message from Kafka topic. And that message will be published from the Kafka producer that we have created in our last video. And in the description, I have provided the link of video. So you can learn how to create Kafka producer with Spring Boot application. And in this video, we'll demonstrate how to process the reports or messages from a Kafka topic with Kafka consumer. And in the previous video, we have created a simple Java example that creates a Kafka producer. We also created a replicated Kafka topic called My Topic. Then we used a Kafka producer to send the reports to Kafka topic. Now the consumer will create to consume those messages produced by Kafka producer. So okay, let's get started. So first I will go to browser and here I will open star.spring.io to create a Spring Boot project. So here I will select the project type is Maven project and language is Java. And Spring Boot version is 2.3.4 and here group ID. And then artifact ID. So here I will write artifact ID is Kafka consumer. And the next we need to change, we can use any version of Java. Here I am using Java 8. So next click on add dependencies. So first I will select Spring Web. And the next one is Apache Kafka. Spring for Apache Kafka. And after that third one is Lombo that is used to generate getter setter. So we'll no need to write any setter getter if we are using Lombo. And now click on generate and here zip file is generated, show in folder and extract it here, extract here. Now open it and copy the path from here, go to Eclipse, file, import existing Maven project, browse and finish. So our project is imported successfully. Now what we need to do, we need to create a Kafka consumer and we need to define the configuration for our Kafka consumer. So first here I will create and we also need to create the model and we will use same model that producer will use to send the message. So here I will just go and in previous video we have created this example that is Kafka producer. So I will copy the package that contain model classes and we'll go to our Kafka consumer and we'll paste it here. So here we are using the same model classes that the producer will use to publish the message. First one is user class that contains two properties, that is user ID and username, and second one its parent class that is message that just create one property. And the next thing we need to create Kafka listener. So here I will create new package and inside this package I will create new class that is Kafka message listener. So here it will be Kafka. Message listener. So here we have created new class that is Kafka message listener. And at class level we will define the annotation that is @KafkaListener. Kafka listener that is supported by Apache Kafka. And here we need to define ID that will be the listener ID. So we can define any ID. So here I am just writing my listener. And the next thing we need to define the topics. The listener will consumer will subscribe some few topics. So here we will create my topic and consumer will subscribe this topic that is my topic. Now if we will publish the message to my topic, then consumer will consume all the message that we will publish to my topic. and here I will define one method that will be word type, and will print the message on console that we will get from topic. And here this is our model class, that is message, and here we will just print the output reading messages from Kafka topic produced by, that is message. And here we need to import this model, that is our model class. And at this function, we just need to define the annotation, that is at the Kafka handler. So this is our Kafka message listener class. Now we just need to define the configuration for our Kafka consumer. So here I will create new class. So new class. And here we just need to define the package name, that is the config package. And the class name will be Kafka consumer config. And here we have created Kafka consumer config. And one more thing that we need to, so here we have need to define application.properties file, some properties like we need to use server.port because we will run two project. So one will be run on default port, that is Kafka producer will be 8080 and the consumer will be run on 9090. So next we will define Kafka host, that is localhost 9092 is its default port of Kafka server. And we will define Kafka group ID, that we will use this property in our Kafka config. So here we are just defining, and group ID we can give any group name, group 1. And here we will define Kafka listener threads, and that will be like 10. And we can also define Kafka session timeout, Kafka dot session dot timeout, and that will be, we can define millisecond 30,000, and we have defined this property. Now I will go to our Kafka consumer config and will use these properties there. So now I will just open it, and here I need to define the annotation, that is at the rate configuration. So Spring Boot will read this class, and also need to define add grade enable Kafka. So Kafka will enable it, enable Kafka. And what we need to do first I will define the properties. So these are the properties that we have defined our application.property file, and we are just reading these properties value. And next thing what we need to do, so first here we will create the bean for our consumer config that we have did in our producer also, Kafka producer. So here I will just define one method that will be public map its return type, and it will return string is the key and value as object. And we need to define the function name, that is consumer config. And here we will just create this map. So here I will just create one hash map that will be props new hash map. So it will be java.util.maps, and here configs. And here I will return props. And now we need to set the values for all properties. Here we need to specify the bootstrap server. That will be our local Kafka server host address. So I will just paste all the properties value, and this will be the Apache Kafka Commons serializer that we will use, and ORG Supreme Framework JSON deserializer. So here we just provide the configuration for our Kafka consumer. First one is bootstrap server config, and it will define the host address of Kafka server, that is localhost 9092 default. And second one is we have used key deserializer class config. It is just used to set the Kafka deserializer class, and it will be used to record key deserialize. And the second one is value deserializer class config is used to deserialize the value of record. And the next one is group ID config that is used to identify the consumer group. And the next one is we have enabled auto commit config is true. So automatically each message will be sent to topic and will be read by consumer. So here we just defined enable auto commit config in our consumer configuration. And here we have defined session timeout in milliseconds. If we have defined 30,000 milliseconds. So after defining consumer configuration, now we will create consumer factory. In our Kafka producer, we create producer factory, but here we will create consumer factory. So here I will just declare one method, that is public consumer factory, that is string, the value will be message. And the function name is consumer factory. So here we just need to import this model, Kafka producer model. And now here I will create and return new default Kafka consumer factory. New default Kafka consumer factory. And here we need to define few properties, that is consumer configs. Just copy from here and paste it here. And also we need to define new string deserializer that is supported by Kafka, and also new JSON deserializer that is also supported by Kafka. And here we just need to define our model class, that is the parent message dot class. And here we have created our consumer factory. And after creating the consumer factory, we need to create one more concurrent Kafka container consumer factory. So here I will declare at the rin bean annotation at function level, and next I will create the bean for concurrent Kafka listener container factory. And here in concurrent Kafka listener container factory, we just created the factory object and set these three values. The first one, we set the customer, set the consumer factory, and it contain consumer factory all configuration, means it is used to specify a consumer factory to use, which consumer factory we want to use. And the second one is we use set poll timeout, and the timeout, if we are not defining this property, then default it will be 5000 milliseconds. And it is used to set the max timeout to block in the consumer that is waiting for records or messages. And the third one is set concurrency, means how many consumer we want to create. So here we just define Kafka listener, it's a one integer value. In our application.properties file, we have defined its values 10. So it will create 10 consumers. And the next, we need to create one more bean for our Kafka message listener class. So here I will create public Kafka message listener that we have created, and function name will be Kafka message listener. it will return new Kafka message listener. Kafka message listener. So here at function level I will define annotation, that is @bean. So our configuration is done for our Kafka consumer. Now we just need to run, but before running this application we need to check our Zookeeper server or Kafka server is in running state. So here I will go and go to C drive, Kafka bin, and inside Windows folder here we just need to start our Kafka server. So first I will start my Zookeeper. So here I will just paste this command to start the Zookeeper server. Now here we can see Zookeeper is started. Now we need to start our Kafka server. So here I will just type cmd and we'll paste the command to run the Kafka server. And here we can see our Kafka server is running. So here we have two projects. One is Kafka consumer and second is Kafka producer. So first I will run my Kafka producer. That will be used to publish the message to topic. Then Kafka consumer will be used to consume the message from that topic. So first I will run as a Java application to my Kafka producer application. And when the Kafka producer will be start, next I will start Kafka consumer. Kafka producer has started. Now I will go to Kafka consumer main class and it will run on port 9090. So here I will click run Java application and here we can see our both application has started, Kafka producer and consumer. So here we can see both application is running. So now I will go to my producer REST endpoint and here I will just send the message to our topic by clicking on send. Now here we can see message is published to our topic. Now I will go to console and check on my Kafka consumer console. So here we just need to check it again. Here it's showing some exception. Kafka consumer, the group member needs to have a valid member ID before actually entering into consumer group. So here I will go to my application.properties file and need to check it if there is something wrong. 9090 server port, Kafka host, group IDs, group 01, Kafka listener threads. Now we'll go to my Kafka consumer config and here we need to check Kafka listener dot threads. It is the same. So here everything is looking fine. We just need to check Kafka listener ID is my listener and I just try to replace with my listener. And here my topic name is my topic. So now I will stop my Kafka consumer application and rerun this application, run as Java application, and now we'll check it again. So here our Kafka consumer application has started. Now we will just publish the message to the topic with the help of Kafka producer, our both application in running state. And in our Kafka producer we have created one REST endpoint that will be used to publish the message. So then when the message will be published, the consumer will listen and consume this message. Now I will rerun this application, that is Kafka consumer application. And after starting the Kafka consumer application, we will check here that is the group member needs to have a valid member ID, but we can then also send the message to topic. So go to postman and click on send and check on the console. Here we can see reading message from the Kafka topic. And now we will send one more message, new user 234, and click on send. And here we can see user 234 is also printed. So like this we can send the message and publish message with the help of Kafka producer, and then we can consume this message from Kafka consumer. Okay, then we have done everything, Kafka producer and Kafka consumer. Okay, thanks for watching this video.